I was talking on Friday. I had a very good message, but I was talking to myself because I was mute. Nobody heard me. Saw the chat and everything after you all have left. So I'm sorry I spoke to myself on spending my time talking to myself on Friday. Let me hopefully try to repeat what I was trying to say on Friday. And we are just trying to talk about tithe on Friday, right? And tithe, a few months ago, we had controversy concerning tithe. We had different people talk about what their thought is on tithe and what it's not. You know, and those people that are talking about it have no reason talking about tithe because they don't belong to the fold, right? Only those that belong to the fold can talk about spiritual things, right? Spiritual things are not for everybody to talk about because they have no clue what is being spoken about. You know, I have a friend of mine in my elementary school, Mamata, who was talking about tithe. We're just talking some strange things that have no bearing on the word of God. You know, that's what the Bible says. Except you be born again, you cannot see the kingdom. Except you be born again, you cannot understand the things of the kingdom. The things of the kingdom are foolishness to those who are not saved because it has not been given to them to understand. They can only get confused, right? They can't speak the truth concerning the things of the kingdom. Only those that belong to the kingdom can talk about things that belong to the kingdom. Right, so that was the first starting point, you know, that the priest has no clue what he's talking about. It's just being used of the devil. It doesn't matter whether they're making mistakes in the fold or not. Yes, we're making mistakes, but it's not for those outside the fold to correct us because they have no clue what it is that the kingdom entails. Right, I know Sunday Adela just said his own also, but he's also in error in what he was saying because that is not in line with the word of God, right? The titan is something from the Old Testament, no doubt. The servant that was born when Jesus Christ was here, and Jesus had no problem with tithe, right? Go back to the fact that
Paul says everything is lawful,
or not everything all things are expedient,
right?
Right. Everything is lawful, or not all things are obvious. Right. It's all things. Not just using the word. All things are expedient. All things are lawful. All things are lawful, or not all things are expedient. Not all things give you does are. Right.
We take that also where you say that says that letter kills,
but the spirit gives life.
Right.
Right. We need a form of offering in the church that is a given because the church work of God needs money to run it. Anything that tries to stop money through the house of God is not of God, it's of the devil.
The devil is trying to stop
the work of God.
Money must flow into the house of God because without money we cannot do what we are supposed to do.
That is why God is making wealth.
Right,
so that we can execute his purposes, need money.
So whether you call it tithe, whatever you call it, it doesn't matter at the end of the day.
The important thing is that money is flowing into the house of God to execute the purpose of God.
Yes,
people use it to raise their own money, their own kingdom, whatever they do. Yes, but in the midst of the fake, there's still the original. We cannot, because of the fake, hinder the original. The work of God needs money. It doesn't matter what you call it, whether it's tight offering, anything you call it, let money flow into the house of the Lord. That is what is important.
But being a spiritual house, we have a shadow
of what is in the Old Testament that will transfer to the New Testament. Because the Bible says that no word of God is for personal private interpretation. So anything we do must be in consistency, in congruency, in agreement with the word of God. Because that's the only template that we have. Right? When the church built up, you will not find anywhere in the epistles where it's mentioned tithe.
And that confuses some people.
That doesn't mean that money did not still flow into the house of God. They went through a time of transition where they did not have everything in place. But there's something God has put between our ears that needs to help us to establish a kingdom. Right?
Right.
We need. My time is up. I'm going to continue tomorrow. The titan is the minimum you can give into the house of God. If you are not giving a minimum of 10% of what you are making to God, you are not a Christian and you are not going to heaven.
challenge me on that. I will stop there. We'll come next week. I'll be there tomorrow, by God's grace. Okay. Sorry, anybody has one something to say concerning that. Pastor Segun, I have spoken a lot. What did you say, Rob?
Yes, I have also studied along the line because the noise was definitely there. And I felt that, okay, let me think as if I don't know anything about it. I don't know anything about offering. I don't know anything. I just want to study afresh, lest I bring my preconceived idea into what may be right. That was what I did. So I sat with it and I looked at it. And I concluded in my studies about what you said last. The city of God shall yet be spread abroad through prosperity. That was the money. I'm a pastor. And I know what it takes to be the place of God. I just hosted pastors on Friday. And I know how much it costs to host them. Senior pastors. You know? So these things, I mean, the work of God requires faith. But then, when we're talking about tithe, we're talking about the minimum in the New Testament. Minimum. I give back to God from what He blesses me with. More than 10%. I do more than 10% all the time He blesses me. I give back to the kingdom more than 10%, much more than 10%. I don't even think tithe anymore when I give to God. But that is a level. But the minimum that I think could be done in the New Testament is the tithe. And I give 10% of whatever He blesses me with back to God. Minimum. But if somebody stays there and say, hey, it's just 10%, and it goes back to law. You just stay there as a rule and they stay in law. It becomes law. And that's the way I see it. But when it is 10% I can give, I give, but I don't go below 10%. I go a little bit higher than 10% when I give to God. And that is the way I teach my people.
Amen. 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 Amen.
Loretta, you have something to say on it before we shut up. We're already past our time.
Loretta, are you saying anything?
Loretta has disappeared. Auntie Beauty, you have anything to say before I shut this up?
Okay. Yeah, I was trying to type what I wanted to say. So to me, like my brother said, we've done a study about all this for a long time. And what I concluded is that anything that has to do with money, it's for life. Anything that comes from you is talking about your life, your time. Your time is your life. So whenever you are giving to God, out of it, you are giving Him like a part of your life. So it's a relationship thing. And that tent that we are talking about sanctifies the rest. That is, by the time you give out of that tent, like you take that tent out, the rest 90% are already sanctified. So you are the one that is now like, you are the one determining how much you want to get back. Yeah. Some people, they are 90%. Some give their 90%.
Yeah.
So that's what I say. I, like my brother said too, I give beyond that because I don't even have a salary. So whenever if it's one ministry or one thing towards that, that's it.
Praise God. Amen.
Hallelujah. We'll continue tomorrow by God's grace. Let you go. I've taken extra 5 minutes from you all. All right. God bless you. Enjoy the rest of the day.
Bless you. Okay.